and then one. Welcome to 2K Sports presentation of the NBA. But the bad news is there is no basketball. There is no NBA. The game has been canceled. Ha ha! Happy April Fool's Day, baby. This is the NBA, and we've got a great one in store. In this one, you'll see the Philadelphia 76ers against the Cleveland Cavaliers at RocketMortgage Fieldhouse. With Brett Barry and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan, and David Aldridge will be joining us on the sideline as well. And a quick look at some of the numbers for Colin Sexton.
And guys, it hasn't been pretty for him in the past five games. He's having one of those scoring slumps that all players go through at some point in the season. But I know he hadn't lost his confidence, and I expect this young man to get after it here tonight.
Now a look at Philadelphia's starting lineup. Green is up there with Tobias Harris. Then it's Curry. Then there's Howard. And it's Simmons in at the one spot. For the Cavaliers, Garland and Sexton man the backcourt. Larry Nance out there with Allen. And it's Okoro in at the three spot. Do you remember, Greg, if you watched the standings very much when you played?
You know, we were always aware of it. And a lot of that had to do with the goals. I remember early in my career playing for the Knicks. You know, we were trying to win championships, and we talked a lot about home court and having that in come postseason time. So we were absolutely aware of where you were because of the goals you set. But I think that also changes depending on who you are as a team. If you're a championship caliber team that's won it, maybe you're in the midst of a dynasty run, it may not matter as much, but you know how good you are. You can win no matter where the game.
Like the attacking mindset, not waiting for something to happen, instead creating it himself, was Colin Sexton.
Okoro passes to Sexton. Bucket number three. He's a perfect three for three to start.
Uncovered at the rim, finding cracks in the defense here early on.
Just really smart basketball and exploiting whatever holes that he's seeing right now in the defensive squad.
And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have. Staying aggressive and playing under control.
They can't miss 4 for 4 and warming up the burner.
Each trip down becoming more important.
And you need to string some successful offensive possessions together and play tough deep. And that's another basket for them. They have really come out blazing here in the first.
First 1:30 gone here in the first quarter.
And Jared Allen, the big man out of Texas, a big part of his impact is how well he moves as a center. Very long and covers a ton of ground on both ends.
Such a big part of what he does for this team, just work and work on the boards, generate second chance opportunities, and hopefully convert.
Sexton's shot is good.
Great start for him. 4-4, he could be in for a big game.
76ers have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. And with Allen, the amount of four he can cover with a few steps is staggering.
And Kevin, it lets him take away chances and opportunities on D. On the other end, one step to the hoop and he's completely relocated as a target. One of the best moving bigs in the league. They are on fire, just in a great groove here early on.
To the middle. It's Curry. That time on the assist by Simmons.
And with off-the-charts awareness, Simmons makes plays that others simply don't see.
The Cavaliers leading by 10. Sexton for three. Another three for Cleveland.
Their third three-pointer in a row.
And Philadelphia has possession. Now here's Simmons. 11 points last game. Curry gets the bucket.
You got to get up tighter than that. Some players you can give that much room to, but not him.
Sexton for three. Good on the three-point shot. Sexton's got 16.
That's a dozen straight points coming off the trip.
The 76ers trail by 14, and that's a foul called on Colin Sexton. That's his first foul. Wade, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. Usman comes in for Okoro. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Shake Milton, he's checked in for Curry.
It's Simmons!
Now here's Simmons. He's covered closely. stolen by Garland. Played outside. Lets it go from deep. That shot missing. And it's Philadelphia the other way. Their last encounter was in Philadelphia.
And turnovers were the story for them when they saw each other last. I mean, just a heartbreaking way to lose the game. That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint.
Three-pointer, Wade. They grabbed their own miss. Allen. And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two. And Philadelphia gets called for the foul. This is his first trip to the line tonight.
And free throw shooting, not necessarily one of his strong suits. Only about 70% on the season.
Here's what Philadelphia is going with right now. Mike Scott's checked in for Howard. Korkmaz comes in for Green. And Maxey subbed in for Simmons. And it's Wade with the ball for Cleveland. It's a 14-point game. And it's Hausman missing. The 76ers have gone 6-9, shooting well. It's Korkmaz in the corner. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it, and it is good.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Here's Sexton. Plays it up off the glass. He's got 18.
This looks like he's got more feel tonight. Like he's really got a good grip on that ball as he's letting it go.
Harris outside. Makes it off the glass.
Not the biggest player out there, but Tobias Harris confident to get down low, use his frame, and score.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Cavaliers.
Meanwhile, Garland, the fifth overall pick back in 2019, had a slow start to his career. But around the midway point, he really started to take off.
You wonder, Greg, in that rookie campaign, if that's a bit of somebody realizing the length of an NBA season. And maybe he made a bit of an adjustment in his body. Now in his second year, we can see some of the fruits of his labor in the offseason and him developing.
Matisse Thybulles checked in for Philadelphia.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Well, if there were four or five boxes to check in terms of the game plan tonight, they might have checked six. I mean, they're doing everything out there.
Harris outside. And slammed up by Harris.
All that athleticism from Tobias Harris showing that time.
The Cavaliers leading by 12. From past the arc, Prince misses. Philadelphia's gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. And finished off by Scott.
And that's a little lack of fight at the defensive end.
Absolutely. At least on that slam, you're right. That's one way to let a team back in the game.
You have to credit the aggressiveness offensively because that's when you make a play when you really need it.
Here's Matt. After the Cavaliers pick up three. And finished off by Scott.
Oh, up high and down hard with that one-hander.
He got a little extra forceful. You're right with that one. Garland, another three for Cleveland.
Yeah, they filled up this lead 3 points at a time.
Well, a lot of importance placed on outside shooting. And tonight you can see why after that kind of quarter exploding from the perimeter.
And they pick up two.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
Garland, all good with the triple. Now the 76ers on the break. Here's Korkmaz. Had a chance there to cut it to single digits, but it's off target. And so is Cleveland. Up by a dozen here at the end of the quarter. They've kept the tempo quick and the defense on its heels. And it's got them up big. Back to the action after this word.
Needed to do and how to stick them from outside. The defense pretty lost.
taking a look at the 76ers. We've got Mike Scott. Tobias Harris is out there with Quirk Models. Then there's Matisse Thybul. And it's Maxey in at the point. So it's Philadelphia now. After Darius Garland missing on that last three-pointer. Here's Hartenstein. There's Garland. Cranes the three-pointer. Garland's got his third basket of the night.
Garland right now really doing a nice job of staying in perpetual
motion. And Darius Garland picks up the foul. That's foul number two for him.
And really, these are some of the toughest calls an official has to make.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Nance is checked in. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Curry's checked in. Now, here's Maxey. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Here's Scott. Down it goes for his third basket in as many tries. A lot of great talkers over the years. Trash talkers on the floor in this league. You think they do it more to get themselves going, Greg? Or do they do it with the purpose of getting under their opponent's skin?
And Kevin, that's a great question. And believe it or not, you see both. I've seen guys who do it to get under your skin, but I've also seen guys that do it for their own benefit. That's how they derive their confidence. And so it's about you figuring out what works for you. I've seen some guys, they don't say smack. They don't say a word during the course of the game. But they will cut your heart out. So it's just about what fits your personality in terms of making you play your best.
Well, I'm glad you don't trash talk here on 2K, Greg. I'll tell you that.
No, we don't do that.
Cleveland leading by 15. Eyes of three. It's hauled in by Harris. Harris has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Shooting 40%. It's good. And here is Curry. His last outing at 8 points. And Philadelphia decides to take their first timeout right here.
Well, whether things are good, bad, or indifferent, coaches will have adjustments to make throughout the course of the game.
Yeah, not just there to pump up or to discipline players. You got to make sure that the coach makes the proper adjustments and has his team right mindset to carry it out.
So it's both teams making substitutions here.
And taking a look now at the stats for Sexton. He's one of the standouts over the last month, putting up about 24 points per, 4 assists, and 3 rebounds. And very few players in the league can go out and produce like he has. Just a great stretch for him.
They keep playing like this, and you know in arenas, especially at home, the star player is playing this well, those MVP chants come raining down.
Yes, that goes in. Allen's got 9.
And that's the battle. They haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
Bombs up there for Howard, and it's Howard finishing it off.
You have to get in front of Dwight Howard, and he has that kind of room to soar. Going to finish alley-oops with style.
Okoro, the basket good off the assist from Sexton. Okoro's got his second bucket of the game to go. The 76ers trail by 17.
The Cavs really took a long look at Colin Sexton last year as a playmaker. It seems like he's moving more and more into that role of being a microwave scorer.
And Nance kicks to Eisman. No good on the three. So Simmons will bring it up for the 76ers. And after this one, they're home against Minnesota. That game marks the first half of a quick two-game homestand. And Brett, the numbers for Sexton back that up. He's a great scorer, as we know, but his assist totals are low.
And this is why I think, Kevin, there's a lot of consideration where Sexton might move naturally into that guy that comes off the bench and creates disruption with his offensive output. Feels like a lot of Lou Williams type of moments could be ahead for a player like Colin Sexton.
Quirk Miles, who's jacked in for Seth Curry. The 76ers trail by 13. Here's Milton, the pass to Quirk Miles. Back to Milton from downtown. Here's Howard. Persistence pays off as they finally hit a shot. George got 4 points this quarter. Sexton for three. It's good for his eighth consecutive basket in only eight tries.
Bottom line, you need shooters on your team who can space the floor.
Well, there's no doubt he's a legitimate threat from downtown, and he's demonstrating that in this game.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
The Cavaliers leading by 12. Three-pointer on the way. And Okoro with the basket on the assist by Sexton.
Well, that's two bombs in a row from long range.
For Philadelphia, they've gone 7-14 in the second quarter, shooting to the tune of 50%.
Sometimes, trailing in a game, players get sucked into trying to make that home run play.
Now, here's Okoro. 8 points for him. Connects from the three-point range.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
And then Okoro puts it down.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
And the gamble paying off.
And the shot is good. Green's got his third basket of the night right there.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Took him no time at all on that one. And the Cavaliers lead by 18.
They've given up a lot of three-pointers here today.
Here's Simmons. Sweet little floater.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Sexton for three. Another three for Cleveland.
Sexton playing at his pace right now. That's a good sign for the entirety of the offense.
Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Simmons passes to Milton. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Milton's got 5 points now in the quarter.
And I like the back and forth here, showing confidence from Rain.
It seems like they're going to find out who can make the deepest threes. Right now, it's a shootout.
Allen's shot is off. Simmons passes to Courtois, and the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
Just a much smaller defender on him. He does the exact thing at the right moment. Goes straight to the rim.
Philadelphia shooting their first free throw attempt on the night. Allen for the three. No good on the last second attempt here. And so it's Cleveland looking at a 13-point lead heading into the next quarter. And if they keep draining the threes like they've been so far, their lead is safe. We'll return shortly.
Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, folks. Ernie Johnson here with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. It's the NBA on 2K Sports, and let's talk the first half. Colin Sexton having an outstanding game. He ended up with 24 points, 4 assists. Well, the Cavs fans still basking in the glow of their 2016 NBA title for a city that was starved of titles across all sports. Check how huge was that 2016 win?
You know, before the Cavs won the previous championship, the 60s, right?
Yeah.
And then in 2016, that completely changed the mentality of the city.
Well, the Cav team, however, the honeymoon period for that win was dark. Thanks for joining us, folks. We're now just a few minutes away from the start of the third quarter.
Second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Colin Sexton having a dominant impact in this game.
Definitely been challenging the defense here early on, not settling for anything outside.
And you want these kind of nights where you can start to see those openings before they happen.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade.
for the second half of basketball. And so in the game for the Cavaliers, Garland and Sexton man the backcourt. Okoro out there with Larry Nance, and it's Allen in at the buzzer. On the wing, Green. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Simmons got his assist totals piling up. 11 now for him. Here's Garland. Another three for Cleveland.
Having a lot of trouble stopping the three-point shot.
And Simmons has got the ball here for the 76ers. They trail by 16. Harris, good.
Oh, Tobias just going strong that time.
Cleveland's gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. He gets it in there. Allen's got 11.
How about that? Coming out to start the half, a perfect 3 of 3.
And with a little over a minute gone, the second half is underway. Simmons passes to Green. And here is Harris. Tipped away. And stolen by Sexton. Deflects the pass. And stolen by Simmons. And Curry has it in the corner. Offensive rebound. Goes back out. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway. So a three-point play chance for him.
They're doing work here in the second half. 3 of 4 to start.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Artenstein's checked in. 76ers have shot just one free throw earlier, 1 for 1 in the game.
And their success rate on the season, right around 77%.
Reggie, we hear this a lot. It's almost too popular now to say good offense beats good defense. Being a defensive-minded player yourself, do you agree with that statement?
Absolutely.
Offensively with his scoring average up there at almost 13 points a game.
Say what you will about the value of the three-pointer, but those close-in looks are always plan A. Every trip down, get to the paint, get deep, score.
But only the first miss of the second half, they come out here with authority.
Well, not a road runner with his speed, but Green really has an understanding of how to execute and get wide on the break.
Three-pointer. No good. The 76ers trail by 12.
And what a factor Ben Simmons is on the floor. Does so much for this team in every facet of the game. He's a triple-double threat whenever he suits up.
And it's blocked by Simmons.
How about the balance and body control? Simmons able to send that one back.
And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. Sometimes people forget just how young Ben Simmons is, Greg. This is just the beginning for him.
I mean, and that's what fans are missing about Simmons. His age. You can worry about his shot, but he has a long time to figure it out. He could end up having a Jason Kidd type of career where he becomes a solid shooter later on.
Scotty's checked in for the 76ers. Maxie comes in for Danny Green. Swiped away. Chocolate 2 there. Garland's got 11 in the second half.
He doesn't look satisfied with the lead right now. He wants more, and he looks like he's going to get it.
And Darius Garland picks up the foul. That's his third foul of the game. Matisse Thybulle's checked in for the 76ers. Shake Milton comes in for Curry. Now, here's Milton. Guarded by Prince. Milton's shot is good. Milton's got 9.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Here's Osman. Another three for Cleveland.
More and more signs of the skill set of Torian Prince as he finds an open teammate.
Harris outside. Uncovered. And the 76ers tack on two more.
Disappointing as a player to have such a great game and still be trailing. Not over yet, though.
Beyond the arc. And another three for Cleveland.
Just how awesome is it to watch the best of the best start to dominate in a game?
Now, here's Maxey. D right out. Sinks that one from the post. Maxey's got his first points of the game.
He's too good a finisher to blow that kind of chance, but that's going to be a wake-up call to the defense.
Here's Garland. And the three off target. The 76ers trail by 13. Thybul kicks to Scott. He can't hit that time. North Cleveland has gone 8-12 from the field since the beginning of the third. Steffens offline with his three. Philadelphia's gone into the three-point range four times since halftime and buried two of them. Offensive rebound. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the content. It goes on Torian Prince.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
Philadelphia shooting their fifth and six free throws of the game. The first one falls. Allen's checked in for the Cavaliers. Okoro comes in for Torian Prince. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Korkmaz checked in for Shakeville. Scott hits them both. 106 left to play in the third. Here's Garland. Trains it from beyond the arc. Garland's got 28 points for the game.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Pretty infectious right here. Guys in good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
Here's Stevens. The shot's good. And the Cavaliers lead by 16. 43 seconds left to play here in the third. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
That they haven't lost their aggressiveness here for the second, despite being down.
Nance has checked in for Jenny Osman. Dwight out. He's checked in for the 76ers.
Well, when he gets into a groove at the free throw line, it doesn't just last for tonight. This might be 2 weeks, 2 months, something like that.
It seemed like he changed his mind halfway through the layup, trying to go to something else, and it flat out choked him.
Second chance shot, and he uses the glass on the layup. Howard's got 5 points now in the quarter.
I like how hard he's working on the glass. A strong big man who is excellent at coming up with second chance opportunities.
Out of bounds, it'll be 76ers ball. The 76ers trail by 12. Here's Harris. And slammed up by Harris.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope, he, his only concern right now is getting the points on the board. I don't mean style points. Once again, off the mark by Cleveland. Here's Thybul. Off the mark. And so is Cleveland. Going into the break with a 10-point lead. Their lead is where it is because they've gotten good shots. A lot of good shots. And we've got more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way after this break. Here now a chance to show you our assist of the game. And it's presented, as always, by State Farm.
And he sliced the D wide open with this feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
That's what great passing will do for you right there, dissecting the defense with that play.
And with three quarters behind us, let's see what this fourth period holds in store for us. And so it's Harris who will bring it up for Philadelphia. It's a 10-point game. And so, in the game for the 76ers, we've got Green. Korkmaz is out there with Ben Simmons. Then there's Tobias Harris. And it's Howard in at the center position. And so here's Cleveland. Philadelphia able to drain the three. Garland dishes to Nance. Here's Steffens. And the foul on Larry Nance Jr. That is his first foul of the game. Colin Sexton, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Curry's checked in. There's the pass to Simmons. Popped up there for Howard. That one misses. Cleveland leading by seven. Here's Nance. They get it back. Allen. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time.
A superb offensive rebound. Allen's long arm and feel for how to get positioning helps big time.
Here's Harris. Count that as his seventh field goal, 9 tries. He's shooting 78%.
Just reliable, guys. He's just always trying to make the right play.
Now, here's Garland. Off target with his three. No one near Curry as he lets it go. He clangs that one off the back iron, and down it falls.
Well, for Tobias Harris to take this step, getting away from scoring and finding teammates to become a more adept passer, it's a good sign.
Sexton against Curry. And Colin Sexton with the three. Sexton's got 30.
Down the stretch, he's been flat out awesome. He helped them get the lead, and now he's making sure they keep it.
Simmons with it. Garland picks him up. Good on that shot. And with that, the Cavalier lead is cut down now to just 6 points with that basket from Harris. And the Cavaliers call time here.
And as things present themselves throughout a game, teams have to adapt on the fly.
And timeouts are a wonderful opportunity to just settle in, recollect the thoughts of your entire team. Not just the guys playing, but the entire team.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Alder.
Well, during the break, I listened in on J.B. Bickerstaff's huddle. He said, "I want us to play as though we're behind. We're good when we play with urgency. We're bad when we become complacent. Let's go. Guys?"
And Tobias has a good frame and has good strength. I like to see him go in there and put it to good use on the offensive glass.
Sexton for three. The Cavaliers again can't hit.
And boy, have they been hitting the backboard in this game or what? Kind of surprising it's such a tight game.
Here's Simmons. It's rebounded by Cleveland. Earlier in the game, they had a 19-point lead. Shoots a three. A nice shot by Okoro. And the Cavaliers lead by seven.
If you came to watch a scoring battle, you're in the right place.
Yeah, both of these teams are locked in on the offensive end. It's going to be a high-scoring affair tonight.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Wade's checked in. It's three outside. And the 76ers call time here. It's been quite a game for Colin Sexton.
A smart move here. Talk things over. He's really eating them up. And they've tried a few different looks defensively. Nothing quite getting it done.
And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. And the wide open shot from Green. And again, another assist.
That makes 15 assists.
He's been one step ahead of the defense all game long. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. The 76ers trail by four. Inside, here's Harris. Score the basket for his 10th make. 10 for 12. 83% accuracy.
Again and again, they're dissecting through the defense and creating those high-percentage looks from inside. And this is what dominating the glass looks like. You just cannot be contained.
Sort of reminding me of a little Ben Wallace action here from his years with the Pistons. He's been that much of a force rebounding the ball.
Yeah, just great. Whenever Simmons takes over a possession like that, what a killer instinct.
Timeout called, Cleveland.
And they're allowing too many points in the paint. Coach is going to let him hear about it.
The coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it, make the adjustment.
And now let's take a look at the New Balance player of the game, Tobias Harris.
And in terms of his shooting, this has been one of the more accurate performances you'll ever see. I mean, he's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good looks for himself. But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. And that has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
That one good for two. Garland's got 30 points.
They had to get something, and Darius coming up big.
Now here's Simmons. Defense right on him. Here's Harris. Lays it up and banks it in. Harris has got 10 points in the quarter.
How about Tobias Harris coming through? Critical shot there.
Hooked away. Curry with the steal. Passes to Simmons. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Curry's got 3 assists now in this one. Cavaliers trailing. Greg Anthony and David Alderman. This is Kevin Harlan.
saying thanks for watching. See you next time.